Well, thank you. Thanks, Nancy. Thanks to everyone for coming out. Thanks to Mother Nature for making it so wonderful to be here. Thanks to our friends who brought from the rehab center, who brought these fun creatures, quite photogenic for us here today. It's really great to join my colleagues. You'll hear from everyone up here. I just want to thank them for coming, for the interest, for the sense of urgency with which they approached this action and the actions that we're announcing today. And I would be remiss if I didn't thank my staff and some of the staff of the other agencies who are here. Chuck Fox, my senior advisor on the Chesapeake Bay. Sean Garvin, who runs our office down in Philadelphia, but does a lot of work, spends most of his time here. Pete Silva, who runs our Office of Water. And a special congratulations to Christophe Toulou, who is, he told me, 3 days on the job at the Department of, the District Department of the Environment. And a special hi to Rock Salt from the Corps of Engineers. Some of you know, I just returned last night from my second trip down to the Gulf Coast since the beginning of the BP spill. That response, the spill itself, is a vivid illustration of just how valuable local waters and wetlands are to our health and to the health of our environments, also to our economy, and also to the way of life of an entire community. I've said it many times that growing up in New Orleans, between the Gulf and the Mississippi River, I learned firsthand the value of the water, what it means to a community. It's the very same thing I see here now. Whether we face an immediate emergency situation like the ongoing release that is the BP catastrophe, or the accumulation of daily pollution and environmental degradation, our responsibilities to address the problems and solutions are exactly the same. And that's why we're all here today. Under the leadership of President Obama, EPA and our colleagues in multiple federal agencies have been tasked to strengthen the protections for the Chesapeake Bay in unprecedented ways. And that's for very, very good reasons. Protecting the Bay is about protecting the lives and livelihoods of 17 million Americans who live in this region. It's about the people who live and work here. It's about safeguarding this irreplaceable ecosystem. Exactly 1 year ago today, at Mount Vernon, I helped announce the President's executive order bringing together EPA, 10 federal agencies, 6 states, and the District of Columbia to address the impacts of pollution throughout the Chesapeake and its 64,000 square mile watershed. Today, I'm so proud to help present the strategy for protecting and restoring the Chesapeake Bay watershed, an effort to which we plan to devote unprecedented resources and unmatched effort. This is a far-reaching and creative strategy. My colleagues will go into more detail about specific efforts, but let me say that we are initiating one of the most comprehensive protection efforts in decades. We will be working with government at all levels and engaging the farmers and the forest owners and the water workers and the community groups who know this area best. We will implement broad conservation and restoration efforts, and we will strengthen our work to prevent pollution from the urban, suburban, and rural areas that feed into this bay. And perhaps more importantly, we will implement higher levels of accountability than ever before. We are holding ourselves accountable for nothing short of real, measurable results. Federal agencies are setting 2-year milestones to track our progress and support the state's own 2-year milestones as well. We'll also publish an annual action plan that details the projects, the priorities, and the funding priorities for the year ahead. We'll follow that up with an annual progress report to track how well we deliver on our annual plans. One of EPA's primary roles in this effort is the enforcement of aggressive standards to protect the bay from pollution, using rigorous regulation and enforcement to implement pollution controls needed for clean water. We're initiating rulemaking for CAFOs and stormwater and establishing a Chesapeake daily total maximum daily load, TMDL. That TMDL will begin a strict pollution diet for the bay and the region's streams, creeks, and rivers. We're also increasing enforcement and doubling state funding levels to $11.2 million this fiscal year. Let me emphasize that state partnerships on this effort are absolutely essential. the years of work from Governor O'Malley and others, the efforts of Governor Kane when he served as chair of the Executive Council, and the commitment shown by Governor McDonnell to continue the state leadership on this effort are absolutely critical to our success. The work ahead of us requires innovation, but it also requires broad partnerships, federal, state, local, and private partnerships. The quickest way to achieve success is to work together. Another great example is the Earth Conservation Corps and the Living Classroom, some of whom are here with us and hosting us here today. They're a great example of the energy we need to tap if we want to do this job. And as members of the next generation, they are the people that we are working for today. Today's strategy is a map to guide us down the long road ahead. I have confidence that we will reach our destination. We will create a Chesapeake Bay where people can swim and picnic and fish, and communities where local economies can thrive. And we will restore the Chesapeake Bay and protect its legacy for future generations. I look forward to taking that journey with all of you. Thank you very much.